So here's the variations between FOXP2 and other animals. Monkeys, the rhesus monkey, there's two differences, two variations. A mouse, you can have 20. Our dogs have 27 different variations, which might explain why my dogs will not quit barking. I just realized that. Yeah, barking variations, and maybe they're hearing too. Okay, elephants have 21. Well, they hear through their feet, I just heard. Animal Planet. Possum's 21. A frog is 26. The star child is way the heck up here at 56. Is it related? I don't know, you figure it out. I have my opinion. So, that being said, how can some DNA be human-like, but and some not be like anything found on this earth? Well, let's just look at the percentages. Chimpanzees, they have 96% of the same DNA you and I have. Cats, 90%. Fruit flies, 60%. And yeast, 26%. So next time you eat a piece of bread, just realize it's cannibalism. Okay? Because you're eating human DNA. So when people say it's human because it has human DNA, that doesn't really truly make any sense. Because if it lived here, in our universe consists of pretty much the same or similar proteins, chemicals, elemental stuff. Well, guess what? If it came from this universe, it's going to have some of the same things. So if it's from this area, guess what? It's going to have some of the similar properties. So that explains why there is some commonalities. Okay, just, you know, be careful. Don't eat your yeast. But how can this happen? Can there be so many mutations? Well, heck yes, we can make this in the lab. You can make this in the lab. There's not a problem. But does it live? It doesn't live. The star child lived long enough for it to grow teeth and eat. It's not human. It's not a human deformity. If anybody wants to throw a deformity at me, I'll explain it away. Okay. I'll give you the reasons why it's not that. You can put any combination of DNA together in a lab, but for it to live and fit in the parameters enough to survive, it has to be something different. It can't be human. And how do I know that? I know that from my experience in the neonatal unit. You can have two deformities, two bone deformities, and survive. You can have three, and you might live to be 3 years old. Might. And I've seen that happen. Any more than that, you don't make it out the birth canal. That's why you have miscarriages. Because you will not survive. This one has 24 bone differences just in the skull. It doesn't happen that way. It can't be Down syndrome. Down syndrome is just an extra chromosome on the 13th pair. This has got 56 variations on the FOXP2. Can't be. It can't be progeria. Progeria is where kids age real fast. Well, that's also, their bones get real brittle. This bone is much stronger. Okay? It can't be crate aborted because there's way too much. And it's way too flat. It can't be hydrocephalic. Hydrocephalic is water on the brain. Well, hydrocephalic people, kids, their heads balloon up like basketballs. And when they passed, their skull bones aren't connected. So those are some of the main things we get as I'm trying to explain it away. It can't be. It can't be. Okay? So what does this really look like? Look familiar? Okay, this is just one variation, one forensic variation that's been reconstructed. If you want to go onto our website, you can see a bunch of other ones. We've had clay reconstructions done by forensic specialists, and when we asked them, how in the world did you put a normal human eyeball in this thing? You know what he said? I just cut it in half. When you try to get humans to do some sort of reconstruction or artwork on something this different, this otherworldly, it has to be filtered through human eyes. So a lot of the artist renditions of what it looks like is filtered through human eyes. They put hair on it. They make the eyes look normal. They try to make it fit into the parameters of what they think the indigenous people of that area would look like. But remember, it's all being filtered through our eyes and our paradigm.